Hey everybody, it's me, CybergWar. How are my favorite people doing? We're back for another episode of Down and Out. I am still taking advantage of these awesome ships that came with the free fly. The free fly is officially over, but I don't know how long these ships will stay on my account. I don't know, but I'm going to take advantage of them, I guess. I need to make some more money. Let's see how much money I got here. Almost 1.2 million. Let's see. I'm about a little under 4,000 credits away from 1.2 million. I want to get enough money to buy a vulture. So I'm going to go do one more run here. Vulture is like 1.25, I believe. So maybe one or two runs here of more drug smuggling. I didn't even check my loadout before I left. I'm running basically in the same thing I had. Alright, let's get this aboard. I want to thank everyone who watched and liked and commented on the last couple videos for Down and Out. They're not doing too well, but I guess in the long run they probably will. I don't know, something about YouTube and me putting videos up quickly just doesn't work. I don't know why. They just keep killing the algorithm when you do that. I guess they don't like me, but it's all good. If you haven't checked it out yet, I highly suggest you go back, watch episodes 5 and 6 before you watch this one. You should probably watch the whole series to get caught up on what's happening. Alright, we got the Widow. We ain't got much though, but we're gonna buy it all. There we go. Other people are out filling up. I might have to go hit Area 54, or Outpost 54. Which I think I'm gonna do because I'm not gonna wait around here. Alright, anything in there? Hospital gown. Awesome. Jesus. I could probably sell the box, huh? Alright, let's hope they have some good Widow here, huh? Alright, we're full up. Widow and Etam. So CIG has announced that they are nerfing the distortion weapons, thankfully. Those things were ridiculous. Fights were becoming ridiculous of people just shooting distortions at each other endlessly. They were overkill for a lot of situations. And I'm glad they're being nerfed. They were fun. I think they're also nerfing the crap out of them because the Idris is coming in with that Idris mission. And they don't want people disabling the Idris. I mean, people are already doing it, disabling the Idris with distortion weapons and stealing it. So there's gonna be a 70 to 90%, I think it was, or 75 to 90% reduction depending on your shield strength, your shield settings, or your settings and components. So that's cool. They'll eventually come back and balance it out, but right now it's completely overpowered and not balanced properly. So I'm all for it. And I really wish they would get in there and start putting armor on the ships and start balancing out weapons and making components matter. But you know, that's one of the last things they're gonna do because that's fine-tuning stuff. Engineering and master modes need to get in place first before they start dealing with that. All right, where are we at money wise? 1.29. That would leave me like, running off into the wind. that would leave me like 40,000 credits if I bought the less than 40,000. If I bought the things, so I think I'm gonna go do another run really quick. Okay, where are we at? 1.37. That would leave me about 100,000. Everyone out there is probably like, why are you resetting your bank account? Because I'm never going to get to 7 million in a cutter. It's just not going to happen. So I'm going to have to buy the Vulture. And thankfully I had these pre-fly ships to use and utilize while I did to make the money to buy the Vulture. I could have worked my way to the money for the Vulture. Wouldn't have taken too long. But just running the drugs in this thing with a 40 SKU ship, you know, that got me there really fast. You could have used a Nomad to do the same thing I did, just maybe in half the time or twice the time. Nomad's a starter ship as well. We're gonna head to Hurston to buy the Vulture and change out the salvage heads on there and get to work making money. Well, it was a good ship. It's probably be the last time I get to fly it. Let's move everything out of the ship. I need to save this box. All right. I'll have a box for the Vulture to store food in. Not like I'll need it though, because it has internal storage compartments. Thank you, 400. You were a great mule. I loved it. I think my days of drug running might be over. I've made a few million already. I've just been spending it on ships. So I had like a million before I bought the cutter, and then now I've made like 1.3 million. So I've made like 2.3 million already. Technically, would be a quarter of, or almost half the way to this ship here. This is the one I want to buy. If I hadn't bought any ships. But that's not how we roll, man, in Zero to Hero. You know, we got to earn our way to it. And yeah, you know, Zero to Hero is just not like, oh, I made it all the way here without buying anything else in between. You know, we're gonna buy stuff along the way, other ships. So eventually I'll have that Phoenix. Drake Interplanetary. Mule, the Vulture, 1.26. So I would have 113,000 left, or 12,000. It really is my best way to make really good money, because I'd probably be making, I wouldn't have to invest anything other than the cost of the ship and the salvage heads and buying a few starter missions. All right, we got it. I need to head over and get probably up at Everest. I would assume that's where it is, where I could buy the trawlers. Okay, so Everest does sell the trawler. I just looked. $1,600 per each, so it's $3,200 for both.
Welcome
that I'll need.
To the ASOP vehicle retrieval system.
Ooh, got a drink. And I think I actually have my Rambler up there at Everest. I do. Okay, so we're going to be based at Everest for a little while.
Your vehicle has been delivered, please.
Person's running pretty smooth. Look at this, man. Wow. It was running really bad for a while. Just after they upgraded Hurston, just the FPS here was bad, and now they seem like they've gotten it optimized in. Much nicer. Much, much nicer. Even when I'm outside looking at the city with all the clouds on and everything, it's running really good. At least on my system, and I don't have a good system. It's nothing special. So I can imagine what people running them $8,000 systems are looking at. I'm running at 1440p only because I'm recording, but normally if I was just playing, I would be in 4K. But my system can't handle recording 4K and playing 4K at the same time. The frame rate gets pretty bad. All right, so I got this little storage spot here. I'm gonna put some stuff from local here. Definitely want some ammo. I'm definitely going to be bringing my sniper. Want extra multi-tool, extra this, extra that, extra that. Some extra food. I'll probably be living out of this thing for a while. Do I have any clothing I can put in there? Not at the moment. I definitely want this in the ship somewhere. Yes, I can make multi-tools in the ship. That's not the point. Anytime you make a multi-tool, you're using up your profit. So, let's see here. I only got two drinks. Let's take a third. We'll leave that there. It could just be like a catch-all. There's the box I lost. That's funny. I don't know what it's attached to. It's just lagging behind. Let's see if the box sticks with us through quantum. It sure did. All right. I don't know what that box's problem is, but he's goofy.
Please proceed to assigned landing.
Now I'm gonna run in, set my spawn, and store the ship. I gotta buy the trawlers, and we'll get our little adventure rolling. For me, this took like an hour, and for you guys, this will probably be like 10 minutes of video. All right, so we go to the Platinum Bay, and we buy the trawlers. Should be 3,200 credits, which is pretty cheap compared, seeing how well they increase your productivity here. So we want utility, we want scraper beams, and we want trawlers. I like this whole purple at the Platinum Bay here. That's nice. I don't know who did that, but it looks really nice. Looks really clean. All right, trawlers are on the ship. Everything's set. Everything's loaded. We're ready to roll here. Let's hope there's no idiots out here. I'm just gonna fly away because there's some weirdos trying to get on board my ship as I was coming up the elevator. All right, I got the trollers on. I picked a mission. We're going out to Hurt L5 to get a Titan Renegade Avenger, and then we'll see how it goes. The quantum in this thing is super duper slow, but it doesn't use much fuel. I will be upgrading to the Atlas as soon as I make some money here. Oh, my favorite place, asteroid fields. I'm gonna get used to them because I'm gonna be in a lot of them doing salvage. So when you're flying through asteroid fields, it's good to go kind of slow. I know people want to gun it through here, but just with the way the servers are, you may actually run into something invisible, because it may actually be an asteroid there that hasn't rendered in. So the slower you're going, the better chance you have to survive that little encounter. It's just a fact of life right now in the game. Always be using ping, always watch what's in front of you. If you start noticing damage to your ship, man, stop immediately. You should always be checking your MFD up there in the left-hand side of your ship view. All right, so I own the salvage rights to this, so I am doing good here. I'm gonna scan it, see if anything's aboard it. Anything worth taking, like gold or RMC. Sometimes these ships have cargo on them. It's only cost me 1,000 credits to get this. I'm hoping to make at least 20 times that much off of it after it's all said and done. Might even be more. Doesn't look like it has any cargo on it. Okay. So, I like to shoot from about 60 meters away. The trawlers, man, they have such a wide beam. They just pull material at a super fast rate. I mean, look at this thing. It's already getting it, you know, it started out 90%. It's already in the 60s. But like I said, the cinch is more efficient. You know, if you want to run the cinch, go for it. I don't want to be here all day working on the same ship just to get a few extra 1,000 credits. I feel like the trawlers just give me a way better opportunity to make money quickly. But you do you, I'll do me. If you look around underneath the red circles there, it tells you what your flow rate is. And as long as that isn't zero, you're actually pulling stuff. Even if the red circles say zero, it's and that number is still there. That number is still there moving. You're still pulling material. Because sometimes the server doesn't give you an accurate reading, so I always go by that E under that where that says C skew, the micro skew. I mean, I'm not gonna sit there for an hour if it's saying 0.01, but so I think I got pretty much everything off this ship already. Oh, I still got this little engine compartment here. Just look how fast that thing chunks right through. That granted, it is a small ship, but on the big ships it performs even better. All right, so I got all the material off this thing. I finished the salvage mission, so we're going to switch over to the muncher. So that is alt w. Hold on, let me shut this thing off first. So we're going to fracture the ship. Ooh, that was easy. I like to back up a little. And then this is the disintegrator. There it is. All right, last piece. All right, so I got 4.2 skew. We'll go see how much we have of each commodity in the hopper here. You get about 15,000 credits for recycled material, and then about 6,000 credits per skew of constructive material. So even if that was all construction material, I would get, let's see here. All right, construction material, how many we got? Got at least one skew of the recycled material, so that's 15,000 right there. And then if we got like three of these construction materials, that's another 18,000. All right, we got two of these. Okay, so that's 12,000 credits I'll make when I sell it. Just for that. And then this thing will be about 14 to 15,000. So we're looking at 26,000. So about 25,000 credits just doing that one chip in that little bit of time right there. Wham, bam. And it cut, you know, that's after getting my 1,000 credits back. Pretty cool, huh? But here's the thing, you have to sell it, so you gotta make it back to the station. Oh, what a nap! All right, we're back. My doggies are good. I went to go help my dog, let him out, and get him food, and do all the stuff that he needed, and then it's the next day because I got tired. We got our first haul of scrap and construction material, so we're doing all right. We got a redeemer. Okay, well, that's 20K. I don't want to spend that much. I need to start low. All right, got another Titan over at Crew L4. That's where we're going. Hey, between now and February 26th, you can use my referral code. If you want to get into Star Citizen, you'll get a bonus 5,000 in-game credits. And just until February 26th, if you use the code when you buy a starter package, you will get a free Drake Dragonfly and Red Alert Armor and Shotgun. That's like a $60 value right there. And the cheapest, I think the cheapest you can get in the game is like $40. So what other quadruple A game costs $40? So use that code if you're setting up a new account, and you'll get the extra credits, the Drake Dragonfly and the Red Alert Armor. And I appreciate everyone who has used that referral code so far. Thank you so much. I think we had three people this week use it. I hope they're enjoying their gifts. That's 78,000 worth of credit right there that I spent 2,000 credits to get. So that's 76,000 credit profit. And I'm not going to say it's zero risk because, you know, like, people could find you out here if they wanted to come out here looking. But the chances are remote. Pirates aren't going to spend their time searching, pinging around in asteroid fields looking for people. They go to the places they know people are going to be. If pirates were ambitious, they wouldn't be pirates, you know? We got a 100 IRA around here. That's 5,000 credits. It's a little more. Let's see if we get any more. Let's see how much. We got 0.6 SKU in there, so we'll see what we get off this. Alright, I think I've finished this thing off. Didn't get much off it. 0.8. An RMC. Now we're at the crunch and munch stage. If you wanted to, you could pull the weapons and missiles off this thing and get a little extra money out of that way. Personally, I don't like taking up the storage in a vulture. The vulture is too small. If it were a reclaimer, probably wouldn't matter. You got all that room in there to throw stuff around. I think it would be cool if right there on the back of the vulture, right there on the top deck there where that little bar is, if they put a we call it a cargo grid where you can attach weapons and stuff that you've looted. I think that would be great instead of putting it in the hold. When you put it in the hold, they tend to bounce around and then move your cargo all over the place, and it gets, you only got that little pathway there to put stuff if you want to fill up with cargo. So it's kind of not, there's no incentive to do it in a vulture unless you come across something you know that's worth a lot of credits. But like a little cargo grid right there on the back, like for what, four? And when they have all that stuff coming now that you're going to be able to attach to the cargo grid, like everything in the game is going to be able to attach to the cargo grid and lock in place. That would be a perfect time and opportunity for that. CIG, make it happen. All right, so we're only going to get one SKU out of this. So it's going to be 2.8 SKU. Or no, it's 1.8 SKU. Of a total material we pulled, that's, I don't know if that's worth it, my opinion. I think that one, those 1,000 titans, 1,000 credit titans we bought, pay better, give you a way better return. Yeah, look, that's all construction material. I don't even have enough to do a recycled. So there's one box for that 5,000 credit mission. That was not completely not worth it. At least for the Origin 100 eyes. There might be something else for the 5,000 mission. But, I mean, we got some material in there. We'll eventually pop out quickly. But, yeah, big difference. Look at that. The 5,000 versus the half of this for the 1,000, you know? Okay. Getting four boxes of material on the 1,000 credit, one box for the 5,000 credits. Not worth it at all. I'll only make it, you know, I'm not gonna make much on this. All right, let's go check out the Scorpius that's over here. That costs $5,000. All right, so I'm gonna switch out the head here, and I'm gonna use the tractor beam and the abrade head because this ship has a lot of little areas to get into, and it'd just be easier to use a tractor beam to get the beam inside those little nooks and crevices. Talking about it like it's an English muffin. So I pressed Alt-D to turn off my tractor beam, and now I'm just using the scraper head to get the wings. Because when you got the tractor beam going, your scraper tends to just focus on the middle, and it's hard to get out into the outer parts of the vehicle you want to get. So if I wanted to, now would be the perfect time to go out there and remove the weapons. You might have to get into the cockpit and unlock the ports by hitting Alt K when you're inside there in the pilot seat. But I'm not gonna bother. I don't have room for it in the ship. That's one of the drawbacks with the Vulture. Let's go empty the hopper. So it looks like I've spent, for some reason, I'm thinking that 100i was 5,000 credits, but it might have been 1,000. I'll have to double check. Because all the other 100i's I see in the contract manager are 1,000, so maybe I was mistaken. But still, I would avoid the 100i's for the simple fact they don't contribute much material. These are constructions, so that's 12,000 right there for those two, roughly, depending on the price. All right, that's 18,000. So just from that 15,000 credit Scorpius, we made 13,000 profit already. I have to check my contract manager. Uh-oh, there we go. I was gonna say, uh-oh. All right, so that's 16,000 right there. So 18 plus 16 is 34. Plus another 16, that's 50. That's 50,000 worth of material off of that one Scorpius for 5K. And here's another box, look at that. Granted, some of this is left over from the 100i. So for 6,000, you know, you made all that money. And then when I got a little bit of stuff left, I like to craft just an extra multi-tool. And a tractor beam attachment just to keep in the ship here. There's other stuff you can do, the Cambio Light SRT attachment, or the canisters. You can get a full canister if you need to repair something on your ship. Get an empty one if you want to go pull material. So, and we still got almost one SKU of material left. Most of it's construction material. So I'm going to go do one more ship, and then we're going to head back and see how much we made. And I'm going to double check the price of that Origin 100i. I thought it was 5,000. You see, that Origin 100i is 5,000 too. So yeah, I'm pretty sure we spent 5,000. All right. I don't have any other 1,000 credit ones here. I think I did them all. Well, here's a couple. The Vulture, Mech L3, Arclight L4. Where's Arclight L4? It's way up there. We're just gonna head back to Aircorp and sell what we got. That's what I'm gonna do. Since I got nothing on the way there, and I don't feel like flying way out of my way and then flying back. All right, so we got 12,000 credit investment. We'll go see how much we made. Dang, did they do more work on the clouds here? Holy cow. I swear every time I come to ArcCorp, it's looking better and better and better.
Hello. Please proceed to assigned landing bay.
Especially if you're here at the golden hour. Oh man. It's just amazingly beautiful. I always turn my lights on as I approach the station, just so you're more visible. The lights really help the fine ships in the sky now. Wow, look at this. Look at this. I've got to look at the beauty here. Oh my gosh. Unreal. If any planet in the entire game benefited from volumetric clouds the most, it was definitely Arcorp. Hurston's is pretty damn sweet too. Got a little traffic jam going on here. There we go. Hey, look at that. The coating worked. They didn't slam into each other. Holy cow, the sun's so quick. It was just sunset when I was coming in for a landing. I've only been here about 5 minutes. Change clothes. Maybe 10 minutes. All right, so we invested 12,000. Go see how much we made. 12,000, we did 4 ships. So it's average of 3,000 a piece. So we got 6 skew. Dang, nice. So that's 40. That'd be 82,000 almost. All right, so just a hair under 82,000 right there. So that's 70,000 profit already, and then everything else is more profit. So 70K we made so far on that 12,000 investment. We didn't have to shoot or smuggle or kill anyone or just get in any dogfights, risk our lives to ship, other than avoiding asteroids. I didn't see how many construction materials I had. So 9. Dang. So that's 112,000 total. $124,000 I made off those 4 ships. Wow. And there's still a little bit left. I'm at 232,409. Okay. And I literally could have filled up the whole ship. I didn't even fill it halfway up. So that tells you how much you can make salvaging. All right. Let's go sell those envelopes. Oh, I can sell those right here, can't I? No, I got 18 Year of the Dog envelopes. Okay, let's sell them. Be another 9,000 credits. I'm just patrolling the floor of Lyria here. Looking for ships to claim. Oop, I got something out there. A Valkyrie. Figured there'd be something out here by Elsewhere. All right, let's avoid the turrets of Elsewhere and go check on this Valkyrie. So if this says game rules, ooh, his hatch is already down. All right, game rules. It's open for business. I'm gonna go in, turn the shields off. I gotta put a spacesuit on. I think that should be good. Yeah, let's go check it out. I don't see anything going on. It says game rules, so that means the ship's been abandoned and whoever owned it claimed it now. So it's free for the taking. But you never know. I've encountered these things where they were traps, so. I'm gonna check it out. See if there's any weapons stowed aboard. You didn't know, right here, there's a weapons rack in between the chairs. That's why I'm checking this area. Sometimes people store boxes back here with stuff in them. I guess I'll Alt-K it anyway. It's not letting me unlock the ports. Oh well. Just gonna shut it off. Gonna be some good munching on that thing. Alright. Alright, so I'm gonna start out with the trawler. And just take everything I can off of it. Once I get this whole top part done, I'll go inside, flip the ship over, and do the bottom. And if I need to, I could actually go unload and come back, since I know where it is. I'm getting back here to find it. Pretty easy. There is a ton of material on this ship. It's nice. We're at almost 7 SKU already. And that's just RMC, so that's 16,000 credits each. You know, that's 100,000 credits right there. And I've only done the top half of the ship. I'm gonna go in there and flip it over and do the bottom half. The ship's in pretty bad shape for me salvaging it, so I gotta be really careful when I dump this thing upside down so it doesn't soft death on me. If it were to soft death upside down, I'd have a heck of a time getting out of here, seeing as this ladder is basically the only way out. Probably be better to go out the side door here. I didn't unlock the ship. Oh well. Alright. Oh. Low gravity on the moon. There we go. All right, I stripped everything off. I'm gonna land. I'm gonna pull out all the RMC and put it on the cargo grid. And then I'm gonna chunk up. I'm gonna munch up this thing. Wow, look at all that. We got 9.5 SKU of RMC off that one ship. Sweet. That's gonna be like 140,000 credits right there. And who knows, I'm gonna get a probably 13 to 16 SKU of construction material too. All right, let's crunch and munch. So we got 4, 6, 8, 9 boxes. Nice. And 23.5 SKU. Wow, okay, it's gonna be a challenge to get it all aboard. Nice. All right, disintegration ray. We're gonna take out the little pieces first, and then we'll pull those out of the hopper. Make room for the big piece and try and get as much of it as we possibly can. Alright, I got 2 big pieces here. One is 14 SKU and one is 10.5. I need to clear out some of the hopper. make that work. I probably won't get like one SKU of it. All right, so I got all that. So do I do, I should probably do the 10 SKU first. Hopper's empty. Now I'm gonna grab that other piece. Hopefully I'll only lose like 2 SKU on it. All right, so I got 1.1 SKU left. I'll take a 14.4, which will actually only be 12.9 because I can only take, or 11.9. So I'll lose like 2.5 SKU, which whatever. I'm gonna be filled. The hopper is gonna be completely filled, and the storage hold is full too. What is that? Those are the weapons racks from the seats. Okay. That's funny. All right, let's get out of here. Try not to get shot at. All right, I'm not even gonna bother to get out of my uniform here. My armor. Just gonna go. In the future, you will not be able to run into Arclight wearing full armor and armed. Nor will you be able to fly your ship in this. You'll have to wear a flight suit or clothing. Or light armor in some instances. I think in the fighters, they'll let you wear light armor. But medium and heavy armor people will not be able to fly ships. You might be able to sit in the chairs. You definitely won't be allowed into certain UEE controlled areas such as spaceports. Be aware when things start happening in the governance and the jurisdictions and the affiliations, the gang affiliations, everything start taking effect soon. You're gonna have to be more aware of what's happening around you and where you're going. When you try to get through these things and you're gonna get scanned, literally scanned here. As you go through, you're gonna have, like, you're gonna get stopped here. They're gonna ask you what you got. You're gonna have to go here, put your credentials in, see if you're allowed here, if you're a wanted person or whatever. And then you're gonna have to go through here and get scanned. If you have anything illegal, they want you to drop it here before you go through the scanner. If you don't, you're gonna get shot here or arrested. So yeah, it's gonna be just like a real customs area. I can't wait. It's gonna be fun. This game is a simulation. So get used to it. A lot of people are gonna be out in the wild more anyway. You're gonna be able to camp and set up shop. There are going to be outposts you can log in and out of. You can be able to rent beds at those places and whatnot. You know, R&Rs will be less restrictive. They're like truck stops, you know. People are going to have gang affiliations. They'll be able to hang out in those territories. We're going to have pyro. We're going to have all kinds of places, you know. It's just that when you come into these government-run places, you're going to have to abide by their rules. And everyone knows government is authoritarian, no matter how altruistic they claim to be. They are big inhibitors of movement, rights, making money, and whatnot, you know? I wouldn't even be surprised if you had to pay visa fees and stuff entering and exiting these places. I wonder if they'll ever implement a type of income tax payable to the governments. You know, they'll keep track of all your profits you make over time. You'll have to get, every time you make a transaction, you'll have to pay a tax or pay a percentage of income to the UEE. I don't know. That is going to be weird, man. If they do. I just thought of that. Like, wow, is there going to be a taxation system in Star Citizen? One can only think. I would imagine so. Since they already charge a transaction fee to use the bank transfer system. And is the UAC, is that going to be the only currency in game, or are there going to be different currencies depending on what territory you're in? I wonder what Tony Z's got up his sleeve about that. Like, if you go to Pyro, why would they accept the UEE's credit system? Why wouldn't they have their own currency barter system, you know? Or even Nyx, Delamar. They're not part of the UEE. They fought and liberated themselves from the UEE. Why would they use their money? Their big, huge place there is called the Grand Barter. All right, so 94. Oh, I didn't see how much I got. I got 247.4 right now. So, 247.4. So I was at 247,000 just from the RMC. I made, man, 121,500. I still have all that construction material to sell. We actually have to go back to the ship and unload it all and then sell it. Look at, there's 13 SKU of it just here. That's another 30. That's 78,000 right there. Plus what's in the hopper. So I've made almost 200,000. Just a hair under 200,000 credits already. Plus the 13 SKU at 60, 70. It's another 80,000. So that's 280,000 for the Vulture on that one run. And I didn't pay a penny to get it. Now all I gotta do is go back, pull the Vulture, empty out the hopper, go back and sell it. All right, another 72,000. So we're at 518.9. Made 271,500 credits on that one Valkyrie. Nice. Oh, and I gotta sell my two envelopes here. Get rid of those, huh? Another 1,000. Hey folks, look at that. You make really good money. Oh, I started out at like 100,000. I had less than 100,000, I think, at one point. I'm at 509,000 here, just doing did four contracts and I found one ship. I might just stick to finding ships, but you can do either or if you can't find them. Pretty sweet. I'm gonna make a lot of money with this Vulture. Literally 10 more days like that, and I have that Phoenix, you know. And I've bought the Rambler, and I bought the Vulture, and I've had never really been out of money since I've started. Food, anything. Things are going good. Until the wipe. I want to get this done before they do the wipe, so I don't have to start from zero again. CyberWar signing off. I love you guys. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button. More subscribers makes more fun. Subscribing is free. If you want to support the channel, watch more videos, subscribe. Or you can become a channel member if you want. That starts as low as $1.99 a month. You get exclusive access to certain videos, and you get early access to certain videos and other perks. So, check me out over on Twitch. I should be starting streaming really soon. I'm trying to formulate a schedule for Twitch. And I will see you guys later. I'm out. I love you guys. I don't know where is my oh god, he looks so weird doing that. Let's do that again. It's almost like a fake smile. Okay, I'll see you guys later. Peace.